Hey guys, salut mes amis, och hallo gubbar. Maxim here. In this video, I want to focus on NVIDIA control panel settings that you can use to get a slight FPS boost in CSGO. I'm gonna start with NVIDIA and do AMD in another video. I can tell you right now that I noticed a significant difference on maps like Nuke, for example, after doing this, and everything seemed like it went smoother for me. Most of what I'm going to share are tips coming from a Reddit user named I'm Thor, I think. But I'm also going to add my own tips to the video. So begin by closing the game and other unnecessary things that you have open. If you have installed your NVIDIA graphics drivers, you should be able to right-click and access NVIDIA's control panel. If not, you can probably just search it and find it. On the first page, you should get Adjust Image Settings with Preview, and here you want to choose Use the Advanced 3D Image Settings. So now go to Manage 3D Settings, and here's where we will be. From here, it's very important that you go to Program Settings and add CSGO as the program you would like to customize. The reason we're not choosing the global settings is because you don't want to risk screwing up the performance for other games you're playing. Also, you might have more or less features than what I do, but the most important ones are in this video. Ambient occlusion. This is a lighting effect that you want to turn off. Anisotropic filtering reduces blur and fuzziness to enhance the image quality. I recommend turning this off as it might help against details that might be considered distracting in the game. And all these anti-aliasing settings, make sure that they're set to off, and that the anti-aliasing mode is set to application controlled. This makes sure that the anti-aliasing video settings in the game are controlled by you, so you can get your preferred settings. CUDA GPUs basically allows whatever graphics card you have installed on your computer to work with the famous CUDA platform. Here you want to select Use these GPUs and make sure you add all if you have more than one to get the best performance. Maximum pre-rendered frames is a buffer used to store data for the GPU. Increasing this value can result to smoother gameplay when you have low FPS, but I still recommend setting this to 1, especially if you have medium to high FPS already. Multi-frame sampled AA, also known as MFAA, is another type of anti-aliasing method which you don't really need with CSGO, so you can turn it off. Multi-display mixed GPU acceleration is a feature based around OpenGL, which isn't needed for CSGO, so it doesn't matter what you do, but I'll set it to single display performance mode anyway. Power management mode. This doesn't really need an explanation. You obviously want to select prefer maximum performance. If you can change the preferred refresh rate, select highest available. Shader cache. Now some people say turn this off, some people say turn it on, but my answer is that it depends. Your shader cache is stored in your temporary folder on your C drive. Now, if your C drive is a fast drive, like for example an SSD, you should turn shader cache on. Only turn it off if your shader cache isn't an SSD or if you have a slow performing drive. Next up, we have some texture features. This one should be off, as it's almost like the previous feature that we also turned off. This next one we can skip. It won't do much in the game anyway, but I'll just allow it for now. And on quality, you want high performance. For the last texture feature, you want it to be off, unless you're using this in game. But honestly, I wouldn't use it myself. Threaded optimization. Select on, as it allows CSGO to take advantage of multiple CPUs if ever needed. Triple buffering is only useful if you have VSync enabled, so you should definitely select off. VSync should be off, there's no exceptions. In CSGO, you want as little to no input delay possible. This feature is only relevant to VR, so it doesn't matter what you choose. Now all you do is hit apply and you're good to go. So that's the most important aspect of the NVIDIA control panel settings for CSGO, and I hope I could help you guys out. Make sure you follow me on other social medias as well to keep update with what I do. I'll see you guys soon. And go bananas.